cutting a man break from the causes of darkness. Any man that is succeed to go came from a good point that are bosses. Has causes in his family. He at the way has causes in his family. Our daddy, the bishop, has causes in his family. Everybody, I do, I have causes in my family. But I bring through them. You can break through from anything if you are willing to pray. One of the first key to breaking out for any kind of generational causes, number one, is intercessory prayer. When a man begins to pray, every covenant that was initiated against him is threatened. The foundation of that covenant begins to shake. When a man begins to pray, everything that is darkness around his life begins to give way. I'm not talking about too many prayer, no. I'm talking about strong intercessory targeting prayer. The Bible said, as soon as Zion targeted, he shall do prayer. The Bible asked him, say, can a nation be born in a day? Is it possible for your destiny, which is a destiny that's supposed to reach the nation, be born in a day? You see, I don't know whether this is possible for a nation to be born in a day. He said, it is possible. As soon as Zion targeted, he shall give birth. That is to say, that every great man, every great woman, may actually be living in a child. But when that child begins to pray, the greatness begins to give birth. But the giving birth of that greatness comes by tragedy. Have you been to the hospital lately and seen how women give birth to a child? There has never been a part of any child without tragedy. There will be some level of pain and cry. Blood must be tested. Blood must be shed. Many a time the many women are not praying for that choices of darkness, their attacks at night are still there because they do not like to pray. If the attacks are coming at night, right at that time of the night, I'm making you pray. That causes you pray. When the devil wake up to come to attack you, wake up to attack him. The Bible says, God will give strength to them that will take them back into the gate of the enemy. That at that time, when strength can only be supplied to you, when you are willing to fight. Are you willing to fight for your destiny or do you want to die a cheap death? I realize I don't want to die like a chicken. I find that people dying in my family anyhow, in my extended family. Anyone that married the family had to die because I should never wish that death. When I gave my life to Christ, they came and asked me, why did you give your life to Christ at night? A demon come to oppress me, an old woman come to sleep with me, an old man come to kill me. I asked the Lord, why? I thought I'm born again, everything become new. So feel this is what we call spiritual warfare. If you don't rise and pray, you will die a cheap death. I realize one of the reasons why pastors die anyhow is because they don't pray. Did you tell me this evening was going out and I said that nothing happened to you? You don't know how many times I have come out of asking and nothing happened. When a man begins to pray, what thing others cannot give him? It's a lie. I know with angelic peace, the supply strength unto me. The Bible says you shall give his end a star over me, that you shall not dash your feet to the ground. When a man begins to pray, he will disconnect himself from any generational process. Every ancestor's patterns are broken. Prayer is a piece of nothing prayer. Prayer is the strength of a believer. When a man does not pray, he will die a cheap death. I assure you, the devil can say, I will kill you tomorrow, and he will succeed because you are a man that does not pray. Prayer is legislation, prayer is wisdom. When a man begins to pray, he implants another coding from his destiny. When a man begins to pray, he begins to rebel against the system of darkness. Prayer is one of the pathways I have found that a man can disconnect himself from every cause of darkness.
Yeah.
Don't worry, you say nobody can marry your family, don't worry. Continue to pray. A time is going to come when that yoke from darkness will break. And when that yoke is broken, you will discover you are the first that will break through the patterns. Yeah. They say nobody can go to steal your family, don't worry. I don't pray with Baba who put you there. I don't care which grandfather put you there. Begin to pray. You will journey to a point in the spirit. You will meet a great grandfather that put that nonsense. You will stop it. And you will remove your name there. Do you realize that we are fighting a lot of battles today because our parents did not fight them?
Yeah.
You can carry over warfare in the spirit. You have had the habit that they said that he that fights and run away need to fight another day. That is the reason why you are fighting every day. Fight and die. If you don't die, you will rule. So that you don't need to fight again and again. Today we are fighting a lot of battles because our parents ran away from me. I don't want to run away from any battle. I want to face the devil right now, and I want to succeed. When you want to break through the curses of the family, you have to begin to break. When you begin to break those patterns with God, if the devil is to attack you by 2 o'clock at night, wake up 2 o'clock and say you must be from 2 to 5. Let the demons come and find you away, playing in those. Let me see how they will attack you. It's because you are sleeping at that time and they are taking your name to all kinds of location. The doctor told you will die by 9 a.m. Wake up by 9 a.m. in the morning, praying in tongues. It is better for you to die as you are praying. Yeah. You realize that prayer is the preceptive life. When you are about to die, that's when you will see the Lord. John the Beloved was in the island of Patmos, was banished to die. All the apostles were killed during the time of the persecution by Emperor Nero. But when they banished to the island of Patmos to die, as he was about to die suddenly, the Bible says, and was in the spirit on the last day. When his eyes was closing to die, that was when another hand opened. I remember when I was diagnosed with appendix, they told me, the Lord prayed me in 2 days I would die, my stomach swelled up like this, I said, no problem. I said, I will never go to the hospital to be operated. Why do I have to believe the doctor so much? Everybody in my family have to be operated on appendix. I say it will not be me. I am not anyone. My name is Billy Cephas. I have belong to the Lord. I may be the son of Cephas, but I also am the son of Elohim.
Yeah.
I'm the son of the Lord. You are the only one that believe you are from the tribe of Israel. No, you also belong from the Lord. Your grandfather was able to give it to you. So if your grandfather put a curse in your life, God has put a blessing in your life.
Yes.
Just that you don't believe that God is your father in love, my friends. God is my grandfather, God is my great grandfather, God is my father, God is my mother. If my grandfather cursed me, the Lord has blessed me. Which report will you believe? I choose to believe the report of the Lord. But the problem is, if you have not come to that level of understanding and begin to pray, you will not journey into the reality that the Lord has apportioned unto you. The Bible speaks in the book of Ephesians. It says, God has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. There is a blessing the Lord has blessed you with. But you must journey in the realm of the Spirit to take hold of them. I don't need the blessings in the Spirit that want them in my life. Here in the Ephesian community, we want the blessings of our Father Abraham, our Father Isaac, our Father Jacob. Why do you believe that it's your great grandfather and ancestor that will only bless you? No. There is the strength of God in your life, but it has been lying dormant. When you begin to pray, the giant in your world, you feel like a giant slayer. You become like David, willing to slay any Goliath. When all your food can begin to pray and break the curses of darkness over your life, all you will never remain the same, because army will rise. God is looking for men and women he can use. But your prayerlessness can remain there. One of the strongest ways to break through any generational curses is to know the way of intercessory prayer. When you decide that every day you will pray for 2 hours, 3 hours against the curse of darkness, you will provide with the ancestors that will initiate the curse in your family. And you will get wet, you will negotiate with them. And if they refuse to let you go, you will strike them and kill them and come back. Many of you are not to be here. The reason why you are here is because there is a fatigue upon the community. No matter where you go, come back and die at home. You can decide and say, no. There is a fatigue upon my life that is from God. I will not die like every other person, no. Because you did nothing, that is why your life is like that. Life is welfare. You must be willing to fight. The Bible speaks this is from the days of John the Baptist. Until now, the kingdom of God shall not be violent. Only violent men take it by force. I like about the story of Bishop. How there were a lot of times when they had to fight another kind of warfare. The story of a priest who wanted to come down, that the priest refused to be turned down or something like that. Blood was coming out from him, you have to pray and it turned down. When you begin to pray, any powers of darkness will be broken. picture of the life upon your life. Touch not the anointed and do my prophet no harm. If you are speaking to spirits and to human beings, I speak to demons, I speak to the devil, I speak to human beings. Touch not him that has anointed and you can do him no harm. I'm saying, even though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you shall fall on the first word. There is a word and a star that I put. You belong to God, my friends. You don't just only belong to the ancestors of your family. No. There is a portion of your life that belongs to God. But you don't believe that you belong to God.